بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Brothers and sisters, who is the one who is going to take us on the day of judgment from the heat of the sun when it comes close to the heads of people and people sink in their sweat, some to their heels, some to their knees, some to their waists, some to their shoulders, some hardly survive and breathe. People are in agony. People are thirsty. Even the unbelievers wish to get to the fire out of that agony. Who is the one who saves us there and offers us a drink from his pool, Hamd al-Sharif? It is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who is the one who cares about us? Who is the one when we are asleep? He seeks forgiveness for us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We wander off and we go right and left, brothers and sisters. And we transgress against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there is one in Al-Madinah Al-Munawwara, in his grave, alive, Hayyun Tari, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, making dua, oh Allah, forgive my servant so and so and so in London. Oh Allah, forgive your servant and my lover so and so and so in New York. Oh Allah, forgive my lover, your servant so and so and so in Damascus. Oh Allah, forgive your servant, my lover, so and so and so in Lahore or elsewhere in the world. It is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our works are displayed in front of him. And everything is detailed. When he sees, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he sees that someone committed a sin there, what does he do? He makes dua for us. For you, brothers and sisters. He makes dua for you. And when he sees good, he thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that his ummah is doing well. This is why, brothers and sisters, there is every reason for us to celebrate Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. More than the celebration of the birthdays of our children or our parents or great figures around the world, more than celebrating our passing or exams or any other occasion or source of happiness in our life, wallahi, brothers and sisters, without Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we wouldn't breathe this air. We wouldn't be able to inhale and exhale this air. We wouldn't be able to eat this bread or drink this water we are drinking without Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's mercy. Even the unbelievers are given an opportunity to survive in this world, and punishment is not incurred upon them, because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. This is the case of the unbelievers, and similarly with the sinners. This is one of the meanings of the famous verse, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. You see his favors? You see his favors? More important than the favors of your parents, teachers, bosses, friends, neighbors. Wallahi, if you think how much Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cares about you now, cared about you in the past, will care for you in the future, you devote your life to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and this is very little in return to his favors upon us. Don't turn away on this blessed month from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't turn away from him around the year, because there are people, great scholars, great Gnostics, great men of Allah, who don't turn away from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for one breath. Imam Abu al-Abbas al-Mursi رضي الله تعالى عنه says, والله لو غاب عني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم طرفة عين ما عددت نفسي من المسلمين. If Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, if I'm absent one blink of an eye from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, I would not consider myself a believer, a Muslim. Imam Abu al-Abbas al-Mursi, student of Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Shadiri رضي الله تعالى عنهما. And it's our luck if we turn to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the 12th of Rabi' or in the month of Rabi' to get some energy, to recharge the batteries of our hearts with more love and more yearning to him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Others, they consider it a catastrophe if they are absent for one second from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. We should remember him, celebrate, bring family members around, go to the masjid, read his life, his shama'il, his character, how he behaved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his family. He was the best to his family, be the best to your family. He was the best to his children, be the best to your children around the world. He was the best source of mercy to people around, to his neighbors, to his friends, this Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum. Be the best of the people around you, the best character. He was the most tolerant people. He was the most tolerant person. Learn tolerance from him, hilm. Most forbearing person. Learn some hilm from him, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. He wouldn't get angry. You would not get angry, but for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't get angry with your children or family members, husbands or wives, for no reason other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was punctual, be punctual. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the truth, only the truth. Tell the truth, don't make any lie. He sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam was the most elegant believer. In Mecca and Medina, be the most elegant, like a beauty mark amongst believers, Shana. He sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam was the most humble amongst all Sahaba. He didn't behave like a king or royalty. Be humble with people around. Celebrating the mawlid, the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is not only offering sweets or pudding. This is an example, this is an expression. Celebrating Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam's birth means embracing him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Taking his character. Take Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's life, put it in your heart there. Plant it in your heart. That the word Muhammad beside the word Allah is engraved in your heart. It's an imprint. People see you and see the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on your face. I don't want you to be pale, to look like pale people, because lovers usually, when their beloveds are away from them, they look pale. I would like to look happy. And when people see you, they know that you are in love with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Like lovers around, you see them, you know that they are in love. So why don't people tell that you're in love with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when they see you? There are no signs. Let everyone see a clear sign on your face. The sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Attachment to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This means every time his name is mentioned, you say Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. When the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned, then you wipe over your face. Put your hand over your chest to get the barakah and the light. You sit in tranquility. You show awe and respect to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. When someone argues about something about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you come to defend Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than defending your father. Because this is a great honor we have. And if you don't respect Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no one in the world will respect you. And no matter how things are important to you, if you lose respect for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, you're going to lose every type of respect in this society, in dunya and in the akhirah. Brothers and sisters, we are now in the month of Rabi'ah. And the birth of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, which brings happiness to all Muslims, and I'm sure to all of you. I'm saying these words not to encourage you to celebrate, because I know you celebrate. And I know that you don't need encouragements, because you know what distinguishes us Muslims? We're crazy about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And I'm not ashamed or embarrassed to say that I'm crazy about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I am totally crazy about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. You talk to him, you talk about him, I just give you everything I have. And non-Muslims or some deviant Muslims attack him or slander him, and you'll see me a lawyer. You can take my soul in love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I sacrifice my soul in defense of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. You can take it as cheap as a penny if you just praise Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in front of me. But I sacrifice my soul, which is the most important thing in this life, to defend Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Are you able to defend Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? Are you able to give your soul in love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? Are you able to move your hearts, to leave everything, just in love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? People do this for insignificant personalities and superstars, singers, or film actors around the world. Not Muslims. Commit suicides. When a famous singer dies, for example, I don't want to mention any names, you know the names. People committed suicide when they heard that this famous superstar or actor or so recently, and in the 70s and the 80s. What are we going to do in celebration of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Can't you force your children? Teach your children. Teach your children to do salah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned. Can't you tell your friends around about the honor of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? Let me tell you the secret. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to show all types of happiness in this world on the day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. In the famous hadith of Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala an, known as hadith al-mushabaka, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Abu Huraira to hold his hand in this way. The hand of Abu Huraira with the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, known as al-mushabaka, interlapping the fingers together. And Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said to Abu Huraira, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى خَلَقَ الْجِبَالَ الْأَرْضَ يَوْمَ السَّبْتِ وَالْجِبَالَ يَوْمَ الْأَحَدِ وَالشَّجَرَ يَوْمَ الْإِثْنَيْنِ. Allah created the earth on Saturday, the mountains on Sunday, and the green on Monday. Now reflecting on this hadith, why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create the green on Monday to ornament the world in anticipation of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Rasulullah is coming on Monday. Green was created on Monday. More important, what hour of the day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born, or whatever, what hour of the night? The most simple, reliable opinion is that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born waqt al-sahar. This is the sahar time, just the time when we eat our meal before fajr, preparing ourselves for siyam, to fast. This half an hour, 20 minutes before fajr, is when the dua is answered. In various hadiths, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned people seeking forgiveness in that time, in the Quran Kareem. وَالْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ بِالْأَسْحَارِ, those who seek forgiveness in the sahar time. One of the greatest imams suggested or put the question, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this time for dua to be answered? The answer is because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born on that hour. Because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born on that hour, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored that piece of time by accepting the dua of every believer in that time. See how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to show us how He celebrates the birth of His beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He Himself, as we read in a hadith in Sahih al-Imam Muslim, used to fast Mondays, and He was asked, كَانَ يَصُومُ يَوْمَ الْإِثْنَيْنِ فَسُئِلَ عَنْ يَوْمِ الْإِثْنَيْنِ لِمَاذَا يَصُومُ قَالَ ذَاكَ يَوْمٌ وُلِدْتُ فِيهِ وَفِيهِ أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ. That is a day on which I was born and on which I received revelation. Monday. He celebrated, he showed thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on his own birth. It is a great bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why, brothers and sisters, we celebrate Mawlid. And celebration of Mawlid is sunnatun hasana, is a good sunnah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam says, man sanna fi al-islam sunnatan hasanatan كان له أجرها وأجر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة ومن سن في الإسلام سنة سيئة كان عليه وزرها ووزر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة. It is a good sunnah. Yes, indeed, it didn't happen during the early generations because they lived with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was the tissues of their life, was the blood running in their veins. He was the air passing through their lungs. They didn't need reminders of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. We needed reminders of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from early centuries, backwards in history. This is why celebration of al-Mawlid is sunnatun hasana, is a good sunnah to practice, because it includes prayers of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recitation of the Quran, recitation of books of hadith, and praise of him in poetry, which he listened to and heard to, such as Tala al-Badru alayna. We're going to listen to it hopefully from the brothers here coming from Fez to sing it for us. Tala al-Badru alayna min thaniyati al-wada'a, singing in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam his praise. This is what he said to Hassan ibn Thabit, his poet, who used to praise him in front of him. Qul wa ruhu al-Qudusi yu'ayyiduk. In Sahih al-Imam al-Bukhari, Allahumma ayyidhu bi ruhi al-Qudus. Oh Allah, support him, or send Jibreel to support him. Anyone who praises Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is supported by Allah. Anyone who celebrates or honors the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is loved by Allah. Anyone who follows the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saved on the day of judgment by him. Read if you want, and let me end with this following verse. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Brothers and sisters, again and again, I congratulate you for Al-Mawlid Al-Sharif. Bring with it happiness in your hearts, happiness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, joy with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I pray that on this blessed month, Allah brings relief to all people around the world, especially in Palestine, in Kashmir, in Iraq, in Somalia, in the Philippines, in the Sudan, and everywhere around the world. May Allah bring them relief and support. May Allah bring the barakah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to our lives, to our homes, and reward all of those who showed us the way to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who taught us of the maqam of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who showed us the sunnahs of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah reward the singers who move our hearts towards loving him more and more and more. And let me end with one dua. I think it is the wish of every one of you. Let me end with this. May Allah grant you the honor of seeing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this life, in your dream and while awake. Both are possible and given to some believers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us a group of these believers who are honored to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in their dreams and to meet him while awake before we leave this world, to get the glad tidings to the akhirah inshallah, to be with him in the maqam al-mahmood, in the Firdaws al-A'la. Barakallahu feekum.